So let us study the other principle which gives a constitution, or which makes a constitution an effective constitution. So this is the balance institutional design. How does Indian constitution make sure that no single institution acquire monopoly of power? The success and failure of constitution depends on its institutional design. The power should be fragmented in society intelligently to ensure that no single institution acquire monopoly of power. See, now they are saying that constitution should be designed in such a way that all the institutions of the government are equal, okay, and they cannot have, or they should not have monopoly. How? See, how should be a constitutional design? For example, if I am talking about horizontal distribution of power, okay, horizontal means it goes this way, and if I am saying vertical, it goes this way. So in horizontal, we have legislative, we have executive, we have judiciary, okay. So now, if so all of these institutions are allowed to work independently, but we have a system of checks and balance. That means no organ can have monopoly over other. Monopoly means that their own individual, you can say, right. Like legislative will start dominating executive, or legislative will start dominating judiciary. No, such kinds of things or power distribution does not exist in Indian constitution. So we have a system of checks and balance. For example, if legislative is going somewhere wrong, so judiciary might correct it, that this law is not good for the common welfare of all. Similarly, we have executive. So all have independent power, plus all are checking on the functioning of each other so that no organ can misuse their power. Okay, so this legislative, executive and judiciary are horizontal distribution of power. Now you might say, what is vertical division of power? This we will study later on in the local government chapter. Vertical distribution basically means we have higher authority, below that we have a lower authority, below that we have even lower authority. So power goes from top to down in a vertical distribution of power. Okay, so you must understand that how in Indian constitution there is no monopoly, a single rule of one institution. The power is not only in a hand of one single institution, okay, it is divided equally, and all the organs are keeping check over each other. The Indian constitution, for example, horizontally fragments power across different institutions like the legislature, executive and judiciary, and even independent statutory body like the election commission. Okay, we have independent election commission as well, which take care that there is no unfair practices during elections. All the elections are conducted properly in a fair manner, check the EVMs machines, you know, prepare the list of new voters every year. So we have independent bodies as well as so that they can work, you know, according to what they feel is correct, so that there is no interference in their work. Plus at the same time, we have a system of checks and balance wherein each and every body is having a check over other. Like for example, if judiciary is conducting some decision and which election commission feels is not good, so during election procedures the election commission can say that or ask judiciary to revisit its decision. Like for example, if judiciary is saying that certain caste cannot vote, okay, it comes to a justice that certain caste cannot vote because they are illiterate. A law was made by legislature, it was executed by the executive, and finally even judiciary said, okay, yes, a certain caste cannot vote because they are illiterate. So election commission may correct that law by stating that everyone has the right, even if a person is illiterate, he is literate enough to choose his government or which government is wise for them. So the election commission may correct the decision. So in this way, in India, if we look at specially the horizontal distribution of power, it actually takes care of the system of checks and balance. It maintains a balance. An institutional system of checks and balance has facilitated the success of Indian constitution. And this is one reason that a constitution is living for such a long time. Also, a constitution must strike the right balance between certain values, norms, procedures, and authoritative, and at the same time allow enough flexibility in its operation to adapt to changing needs and circumstances. Too rigid constitution is likely to break under the weight of change. Now, what are they saying? That constitution should also have a provision for amendment. Okay, like for example, if we will refer to the gay rights. Earlier, our constitution was stating that they are illegal, or they cannot marry each other. A gay person has no choice to choose his life partner. Marrying was an illegal concept according to Indian constitution. But over the period of time, it was realized that it is their choice. They have their own human rights. They have their own choices and preferences. So constitution is no one to stop such choices. So over the period of time, a change was required, an amendment was required. So constitution should be such that amendments can be done according to the changing need, according to the changing time or value, anything. Also, too rigid constitution is likely to break under the weight of change. See, changes will come over the period of time. Our constitution was made around, you can say, 60 to 70 years ago. Now, if something was made so back period, how is it possible that every time our constitution is correct, or each and every provision in our constitution will cater to the demands of the present society or to the present time? So that is why we have a provision of amendment. We can bring certain changes in the constitution. But if a constitution is too rigid, rigid means it is very restricted and it cannot have changes. So such constitutions are likely to break under the weight of change. Change basically means change of time. Okay. So how should be a constitution? It should have a balanced design, institutional designs. That means no authority or no organ should have extreme power. It should have a principle of checks and balance, that they should have somebody to regulate themselves, to control themselves, so that they cannot make misuse of power. Also, a constitution should be such wherein amendments can be made according to the changing time.